Hello everyone, Treecks here, and welcome back to Donkey Kong Country. We're at part 4, and we are in World 3. Last time we did this first part of World 3, the forest section I always call it, but here we have the water section. Not that there's a lot of water section, but because it shows off an ocean and everything, basically the reason I call it the water section. The world is divided in two screens, like all worlds are, so this one too. But we stopped at Temple Tempest, and let's see what this level is going to bring us. There's something up there, I believe. It's an animal token, I think. Yeah, it's a Rembi token. Rare knows where to keep its secrets, and I know where to find them. Hush, Diddy, hush. You'll get your turn after this. Not this stage, but I think it's going to happen today. But here we have the gimmick of this stage. We have these naughties that are running around in these big wheels. We've seen them in the previous temple level as well. But this time they're going to follow us around. Basically making this a chase level. Also something that's really fun to do in platforming stages. It basically forces you to speedrun levels. That's the reason I like these kinds of chase levels. Where something chases you and you need to run ahead of it. Trying to stay ahead of it and stuff like that. In all honesty, they don't go too fast. As you can see, there's pretty big margin. But that's basically the deal in this stage. Hush, Diddy, hush. You stay up here and shut up. These kinds of levels, there's more than the of these kinds of levels later on. There's also one based on a water mechanic. But these kinds of chase levels are the ones I really like. I also made a couple of them myself in Mario Maker. Two of my stages are chase levels. One of them I even made with a friend of mine. First one, the second one I made myself. The second one you guys have not even seen yet, I believe. That's one of the levels I made after I uploaded my 100th core. So that it's not shown off yet. But we will see it once I start playing my original level course worlds. It is, of course, it is present there, so then we will see it. But I've made two chase levels in Mario Maker myself as well. And I think because of it being a forced speedrun level, you trying to run ahead of something, forcing you to run the stage, basically making it a speedrun, that is something I definitely really like. For that reason, this is one of my favorite stages in this game, even though it is a little bit too easy in my honesty. But yeah, that's just me. I know I'm way too good at 2D platformers, so that is a thing. But I was never always this good. I, of course, became this good because I played way too much. There was a time when I was still young and I have not played this game or platformers in general as much as I had nowadays, so I had a lot more trouble with levels like this or just games like this, and then I really really appreciated the challenge here. Nowadays I don't consider it a challenge anymore. Okay, another secret, the G is hidden down here, by the way, if you go down this final rope of the stage. Oh, but there's a barrel up there, so you don't get killed the moment you fall. That is where they hit the G in this level. I missed a bonus. Seriously. Let's go in quickly then. I think I know which one it is. I need this DK barrel for it though. Over here. Can't believe I forgot that one. Oh, I know why I forgot that one. Because I was distracted. Yeah, I can't kill myself here, because if you get hit in a bonus, you immediately get thrown out. So let's show off the bonus in its entirety first. And you actually get an espresso here. Yeah, I completely forgot about that. Yeah, that's what distraction does for you. Let's find an enemy quickly. You get hit. Oh, now that we're at it, let's show off the espresso mechanics as well. You can actually run over some enemies with espresso. Doesn't always work, but if you go over these slippers most of all, knotties it does not always work with. You can actually run over certain enemies. One downside though, as you can see here, Espresso is not able to jump on top of enemies. That does not work. Okay, and now that I have the bonus, you can just run out of the stage immediately. Do that by pausing the game and press select. You go out of the stage. And everything you collect in that, as you can see by the fact that the explanation point is now here, still counts. You don't have to clear the entire stage just to get another bonus. Just getting the bonus and then immediately leave also counts. Once again, can't believe I missed that. But speaking of bonuses and missing bonuses, we have Orangutan Gang, the next stage, which is basically another jungle stage. You've not seen those in a while. But this is the stage that is famous for having the most bonuses in the entire game. I hope I am able to find all of them. Usually I end up forgetting at least one of them, because there's way too many in this one. Let's get started by rolling around. Roll, roll, roll your barrel gently down the trees. Merrily, 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 merrily. Life is just a tree. Hey, I'm a septile after all. I love trees. Anyway, we're already skipping out on a bonus right now, but there's a reason for that. This is the first stage that properly introduces Espresso. And now we are going to get the bonus. We're going backwards in this stage. Because this first bonus is something you actually cannot get with just Donkey Kong or just Diddy Kong. Espresso's gliding or flying mechanics is actually what you have to use in order to get there. This platform, jump and fly with Espresso, and you can reach the far left of the screen, but below the trees. And there's a bonus here. Very, very hard to find. I don't want to win Winky tokens, or I'm going to fail this one deliberately. And in all honesty, the only reason I ever found this one was because of the game not giving me an explanation point after finding a lot of bonuses. So I kept looking for... There is supposed to be another one. Where the heck is it? And after a lot of searching around, I eventually found that place, and apparently there is a bonus there. There's a crap ton of bonuses. Yeah, I'm going backwards because this bonus throws you very, very far into the level. So I'm quickly... Stupid DD barrel. Don't want you. So I'm quickly going to go backwards until this point where we first grabbed our Espresso. And let's continue with the level now. Yeah, you can see the claptraps are low enemies, so Espresso can actually go over them. That's also a pretty fun mechanic Espresso makes use of. We also get introduced to these guys, Mankey Kongs, which are evil Kongs. Not all of the Kongs are on our side. And these guys just throw around barrels, which you need to avoid. And if you don't, well, you're dead. Or you lose your Espresso if you're riding him. Or her. Still not too sure what it's supposed to be. But it doesn't matter. There's an N here, but don't think that is everything. Once again, like with the very left of the screen, this is another place where something is hidden underneath the line of trees, where you normally go over. There is another bonus hidden here. Bonus number two. Yeah, the bonuses are hidden really well here. There are not just a lot of them. There's also the fact that they are really, really, really hidden well. So let's go show off where they are. There is one plus side on bonuses being hidden so well. Because of them being hidden so well, you actually remember where they are. It's usually the easier ones I skip, like in Temple Tempest just a minute ago. That was, in all honesty, not that hard to find. Just the very first wall after a barrel, and that is the one I end up missing. Okay, we're back at the part where the very first bonus throws you at. Still don't know why it throws you that far, but it does. So it is what we are going to have to work with. It is how Rare made the game. This is what is hidden in those patches, as you can see. Nothing I really want. I definitely don't want a Diddy Barrel, because it takes away my challenge. And I also don't want the Engard sign, because we've already got those. Okay, another really well hidden bonus down here. It looks like to be an endless pit twice, but it's actually in both cases not an endless pit, and it's where a bonus is hidden. That is bonus number 3. Okay, but I do lose my espresso now, because espresso, as fun as he is not able to carry around barrels. Bonus number 4 is over here. Don't think that pit only holds that hidden bonus in the double fake endless pit. There's another one over here. And it's actually where the G is hidden, so if you're collecting Kong letters, you can pick that up there. And there's another use of this barrel. Yes, this barrel is used 3 times for 3 different bonuses. So try to avoid this main key. Take the barrel over here to this wall where another bonus is. I killed that critter with the barrel. My thoughts exactly, DK. Let's get in. Let's scratch off this bonus. We get an espresso here because we use it to fly around. This is basically how this bonus works. Self-explanatory. We get thrown out the other side, and it's also immediately where the exit of the stage is. There's a banana bunch hidden up here, I believe. If you go over these trees. Yeah, nothing too special, but it is there. Just pointing it out, it is there. Yeah, I don't really need you. You lose your animal buddies anyway if you clear stages. So. With that, I've got all 5 of the bonuses. Did not forget a single one. I'm surprised. Usually I do. Let's see what Old Man Cranky has to say this time around. Ah, at last. Somebody to chat with. Well, you've already said that. You've already said that. You've already said that. If you get stuck, come back and see me. Well, not if you only say things you've already said before. Yeah, the old man doesn't get a lot of visitors. He usually insults people way too much. But anyway, I've been calling this the water section of World 3. But that's mostly because of the overworld showing off this big ocean here. But in fact, there is only one real water stage here. And there's actually a hidden wall, a fake wall, right at the beginning, for both the K and an N-guard. So please take that with you while you're going through the stage. It only makes it easier for you. Yeah, I know. When I thought of something to do as a gimmick to play this original game, not making it a completely 100% playthrough, but also create a little bit of a challenge for myself, I thought of the One Kong challenge, where I thought I'm going to be dead with one hit every single time. I could have also included not picking up any animal bodies, but yeah, it's a little bit too late for that now. One Kong is what we're dealing with. And I also still stand behind it, because I also like to show off all the animal bodies, so I'm not going to skip out them too. Might do that in the far, far future. To redo... get back here, stupid fish. Thank you. Might do that in the far, far future when I decide to redo some projects and I'd like to do a no-hit challenge in this game. Then I might skip out on the animal bodies too, making it even harder. But sometimes animal bodies are required for some oh, dang it! Didi, get hit by that clam, please. I'm pretty sure I could have avoided that barrel, in all honesty. I think you can squeeze your way over it. But I did not realize that barrel was there in time. Yeah, in underwater levels, you are forced to grab them the moment you touch them. There's no picking up barrels in water stages, so you automatically pick up the barrel if you touch them. The moment I realized, oh, there's a Kong barrel coming up, I already touched it. Ow. Oh, never mind, I don't need you. That's end of the stage anyway. Watch me get hit by this guy. Final enemy in the stage. You don't scare me. I'm pretty sure clams don't make that many pearls in their life, but still. It's video game logic after all. And with that, we are at the boss of World 3. World 3 has come and gone. Only one more stage to do. Bumblebee Rumble. DK, it's time for you to say goodbye. Diddy, it's your turn again. How does the third boss work? As you can see, it's a very giant singer that flies around the stage. We get handed out a couple of barrels, which we use to hit him. But as you can see, we cannot hit him if he is red. Oh, dang it! Trying to play around way too much. Sometimes you get punished for that. DK, you are not supposed to be here. Get hit, please. Bye. Okay, where was I? As you can see, this is what we need to do to hit him. He turns red, making him invulnerable for a moment. Otherwise, he would become too easy if you can hit him again immediately. That's basically the way they are trying to make him work. So avoid him. Wait until he turns yellow again, his normal color, and then you can hit him. Which is pretty easy with Diddy, because of him holding the barrels in front of him. You can just stand in place and make him fly against you. Or I'm saying him, but it's basically a her. Because I believe the name of this boss is Queen Bee or something. Kind of indicating it is a she. But still, it is an easy boss, even though I died. Never talking about that again. Please don't mention that again. World 3 is done anyway. We are at the top of Kong Island Gorilla Glacier, which is the ice world of this game. What is a platformer without an ice world or ice physics? This one is not an exception. Snow Barrel Blast is the first stage, and as the name of the stage implies, it is another Barrel Blast level. One of my favorite things to do in this game. Okay, first of all, there's a bonus above here, so use the necky to get up there. This is going to give us a token, which I don't want. We've already seen the bonuses. And the fact that if you enter those bonuses, you get thrown back to the beginning of the stage is also something I don't like, so I've decided to skip them for now. But these ice levels are really fun to do, I think. Cool aesthetic, cool music that plays around with it. And especially this first one, because of it being another Barrel Blast level. Ah, amazing, I really love this level. Definitely one of my favorite stages in this game. And of course, don't forget about the ice physics here. As you can see, we can slide around. Even though it's not too hindering, in all honesty, in this game. I have played platformers where the ice physics are a lot worse. That's something I also got to hand out to Rare. I've not really talked about it yet. But when it comes to the gameplay of this level, the way I am about to praise Rare for being amazing in the way the game feels. How smooth the platforming feels. And that same platforming kills me. Karma. Hell yeah. Okay. Let's finish that story, even though I died. Come on, dying is something is supposed to happen in a challenge like this, so not going to fret about it too much. But the way the platforming feels in this game, just the general feel of when going around, running around, jumping around, rolling around, everything feels so smooth. The programming of this game is amazing. That's also one of the reasons I really appreciate the Donkey Kong Country games in general. The way they are programmed in and feel around is just amazing. And it is a party just playing this game, not because of the challenges the game gives, not because of the music. Those are also things, of course, but just the way the game feels when you're playing it. It is really smooth and really, really well done by Rare. Really have to give it to them. that brace. And speaking of giving praise, in this case giving praise to the aesthetic of the stage, just look at how the stage started and how it goes now. I'm going to shoot over you, because I don't want you. When we started, clear blue skies, and now the skies have turned grey and a major blizzard has started. Really, really like that aesthetic. Really gives emotion and feeling to the stage. Yeah, if I have not said it enough by now, Rare, you are geniuses when it came to making this game. Too bad you are not anymore. More on that later, by the way. The future of Rare. Now we're just playing a masterpiece by Rare. In the time that Rare was at its best. Okay, this barrel section is where you end up if you don't take that bonus. You don't really miss out on too much. If you go to the right instead of down to the bonus, you end up there. Tricky little Rambi sign to get here. Oh, thank you. I was supposed to die there, in all honesty, but I'll take it. If you go down here, there's actually a shortcut, but I'll show that off later. Of course, because of me liking these barrel sections so much, I'm going to show off the regular way to do this first. This is definitely the hardest barrel blast section we've done so far in this game. This is really challenging. There's a lot of tricky barrel placements, barrel moving around, and zingers placement here. Especially these ones, as you can see. We move up and down, and the barrel also rotates. Really tricky to do, but also really fun to do. Really cool challenge to do this. Let's see if I can do this first try. Usually this is a very easy place to die in. Get away from me. Thank you. There we go. Really love how the music picks up here. Yeah, the soundtrack is also really amazing. That's also something I can give praise to this game. All the praise to Rare. Amazing graphics, amazing gameplay, amazing music. Music might be a little bit less frequent to hear because of me talking through it and also playing through it. But you can still hear it, so you can definitely see. And most of the people know these themes by now, I think. Rare. It is an amazing game. That's all I'm trying to say. In a lot of aspects. So I'm definitely enjoying playing this game. But anyway, 20 minutes have been reached, so the next parts of World 4 are going to be shown off next time. And I'm definitely going to have fun doing it. This game is a party to play, if you have not noticed. Amazing game. That is the short conclusion I can give you. Thanks for watching. See you next time when I continue with this amazing game. Treecks out!